I'm going to show you something that people struggle with the most, and I did for a long time. You've just one of those things you have to practice and then it will click. So I'm going to show you quite dramatically in large how I do it so that you can really see what I'm doing. Normally I work it over just one finger, but for this I'm going to work it over my whole hand so you can actually see what I'm doing really clearly, hopefully. So this is going to show you how to do the magic ring. Sometimes it's referred to as the magic loop, magic circle, adjustable ring. It's got a whole load of names. I often call it the magic ring because it's magic. So how you do a magic ring? Great technique for amigurumi. I also use it when I'm doing crochet squares, hexagons, because it means you don't get that loop in the center like a hole. You get really nice, neat, tight finish. So you take your yarn and you've got your tail end here and you just hold it in your hand like that. And then you are going to wrap this yarn, the bit that's attached to the ball, put my hook down for a second. You're going to wrap it around your hand. So you're wrapping it around your fingers and you want to cross it over that tail. To cross it over, so you're looping backwards. And then rotate your hand around. And this is the yarn at the back here that's attached to the ball. I'm just going to put that behind my ring for 1 second whilst I grab my hook. This is the one that's attached to the ball. So you're going to go with your hook underneath this tail end and you're going to catch the yarn that's attached to the ball and you're just going to come through like that. Hold on to everything. You can kind of put your thumb on it. And then what you want to do, just chain one with the yarn that's attached to the ball. You can kind of just, you'll feel a bit cack-handed to begin with, but once you get used to it, it's really simple. So then you've got this loop of yarn, and that's your tail end, and you've got a little chain one like that. So keep hanging on to it, and you're going to work your stitches over the tail, this tail, and the loop. That's quite important. So I'll just show you with little single crochets. So I like to hang on to both so I know I'm sandwiching them between. And you just put your hook into the space underneath, catch the yarn, come back through, and just yarn over. So that's one single crochet. Keep going, just do a few more for a practice. That's two. I've actually got my hook caught in my sleeve, so. Make sure you're still sandwiching this tail and the loop in between, like this. So you're making sure you're crocheting over both. I'll do a couple more, and then I'll show you where the magic happens. Right, so say you've done the right stitches that you need, single crochet, double crochet, whatever the stitch is. At this point, you can pull your tail and it will close the ring. Keep going. And then if you think you've still got a tiny little hole, you haven't pulled tight enough, you can be really quite rough. There you go, and it snicks in. And when it snicks in like that, the little chain one you did in the beginning just disappears. So then you have got a really tight little perfect lack of hole. And that is how you do magic ring. That's it. Really simple, but just bear with it. Practice a little bit because you can feel really cack-handed and silly when you're first doing it. So I will show you again really quickly without the waffle what I did. Tail in your hand like so. Wrap the yarn that's attached to the ball around your fingers and backwards so you cross and you can rotate your hand at the same time, like that. And then you come under this loop, grab that yarn and come back through like that. And then holding on to everything, you're working yarn, which is the yarn attached to the ball, chain one. And then all your stitches sandwich between the two. Let's do a few, like so. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you take the little tail end and you pull it. And it closes it up. Now remember, give it a proper tug so it snicks into place. And then you know it's secure. And that's it. Dead simple. I hope you found that helpful.